Tracy's great, and she's great in the episode, and she's really funny, and it's cool at the beginning of this adventure to have her with me, and it means a lot. Yeah, we talked about it early on, about her coming on and what kind of role she could play, and I think it was Will Gluck who said, sexy neighbor, and it just immediately sounded right and sounded like fun, and she's really embraced it and hits it out of the park. We know a new neighbor has moved in upstairs, and they're listening to their TV very loud, so I get sent up to ask them to turn it down, and we've already established in the relationship that I'm the diplomat and she's the one that you don't want to go on a peacekeeping mission because she'll get into a fight. So I go up to tell this neighbor to turn the TV down, and it's this, I'm expecting this old man, and it's this knock dead sexy woman, and she's making cookies, and she gets me to lick the spoon, and it's this whole thing, and I'm completely smitten by her, and Annie's really patient throughout this, and it turns out that what I explained to her is that with him dealing with his Parkinson's, he's kind of like lost the idea of whether or not he's attractive to women, and so he's not so much that he has a crush on this woman, he's just caught up in the idea that she could have a crush on him. And it's really sweet. It's just kind of really, it's in the tone of the show that we've established already. It's just kind of nice. It's funny, but it's got a basis in emotional reality. I'd love it if it was a recurring role for Tracy. She's great in it, and it makes carpooling easy. Yeah, a lot of the stories on the show are based on things that have happened to me and to my family, and based on things my children have done. But you know, enough distance away from the truth to protect the innocent. But I always say, you know, when I talk to my kids about using certain ideas, and they say that's out of our life, and I say I paid for it. There's a lot of stuff that's relatable for everybody, and that's what I wanted to do—a throwback, old-fashioned family show that touched on those just those familiar moments and those emotional connections we make with our families and things kids do all over the world and all over the country and ways the parents react to it, and it's, we never get tired of those stories and finding new ways to tell them.